HIV clearly remains a huge health problem, not only in the United States, but worldwide.
When HIV first appeared on the scene, it was a death sentence.
The original early medicines were less than ideal.
25 years ago, people would be quite surprised at where we are now. Our drug attaches to the virus and prohibits the virus from attaching to that initial CD4 molecule.
You could maybe inhibit the virus before it has a chance to even gain a foothold onto a human cell.
It inhibits the attachment of the virus to the cell, so then it can't fuse.
And so that's why it's called an attachment inhibitor, because it prevents the very first step.
This drug is an example of a drug that was not that easy to get to where it is, and it had a number of development challenges.
The first molecule put into the clinic was in 2001.
We put close to 8 compounds in the clinic before we ended up with this.
So we've been working on this target for 13 years.
So it's been quite a long odyssey to fashion this compound into an effective drug. But we've been absolutely delighted, by the way, it's performed.
Bristol Myers Squibb has been very supportive of HIV and everything we've done.
BMS has had a commitment to HIV for the past over 20 years.
The overall objectives of the people in the team are aligned with each other, and that just allows people to cooperate better, to share information more fully, to feed off each other.
We're focused on success. We live with failure, but we live for those days when we are successful.
I'm honored to be part of this team that has won the Research and Hope Award.
Having that acknowledged publicly energizes me, energizes the other members of our team, and our whole company, that we're doing the right thing.